Hi friends, my name is Shannon Downey. On the internet, I am known as Badass Cross Stitch. I'm an artist, activist, craftivist, which if you haven't heard that word before, craft activist. Today I'm here to teach you how to embroider. And I think that embroidery is my favorite way to express myself. It's my favorite way to put words and design into really visible things that I can wear on my clothes or that I can stitch on a bag or that I can stitch on a giant protest sign if I'm going to a march. So there's so many ways to incorporate embroidery into your self-expression. So in just like a couple materials and maybe 10 minutes, you're going to be a stitching pro. Ready? Let's get started. So the first thing I'm going to do is walk you through the materials and how we use them. The first thing that you need is an embroidery hoop. The embroidery hoop's just meant to hold your fabric in place while you're stitching to make it easier to work on. Then you need something to stitch with or stitch onto. So this is quilter's cotton, but any material will do. You need a needle. Okay, any needle will do. This is a tapestry needle, which means that it's got a really big eye, which is really helpful because when working with embroidery floss, we usually work with a couple strands, and so the big eye makes it easier to thread. I always have a pair of embroidery scissors, and these are very short and very sharp and very helpful for cutting out stitches. So one thing you have to know is that half of embroidery is unembroidering and redoing. And so these scissors make it really helpful to just take out a couple stitches without ruining your whole piece. I use a water-soluble marking pen or erasable pen. I call it my magic marker. I use this to draw right onto the fabric what I want to stitch. Then I stitch over it. And then when I'm done, I take the fabric out of the hoop. I run it underwater. All of the marker disappears and you're just left with your embroidery. And then you lay it flat to dry and it's good to go. You need some embroidery floss. And then the very last thing I have is always just a pair of fabric scissors, but you know, you don't need that many scissors. So that's everything. That's all you need to get started embroidering. Okay, let's get set up. So the first thing that we need to do is hoop our fabric. All you do is you loosen the pin head just enough so that you can separate the two rings. You don't need to remove the pin. It's kind of a pain in the butt to get back in. So we just loosen it enough. You take the inner hoop and it goes on the table. Then you take your fabric and you lay it across the hoop. Then you take your outer hoop and you're gonna pop it right on top. And then what I like to do is I tighten it a little bit. I tighten that pin a little bit and then I start pulling the fabric. And I'm pulling the fabric just to create tension and make sure that I'm getting out any creases. And then when I feel good about it, I tighten it all the way. And at that point, it should sound and feel like a drum. That's how you know it's tight enough. And then you're hooped and you've got a beautiful blank canvas here on which to create. Okay, once you're hooped and you have this blank canvas, you have a couple options. You can use your erasable pen and draw directly onto the fabric, the thing that you want to stitch. But some folks maybe don't feel like they're a good drawer or they don't like their handwriting and they want a little help. Sometimes it's easier to just draw it on paper first and then transfer it over to the fabric. But you could also just go to your computer and type up some words or design an image in Canva or some other free tool and print it out. And then you've got your design on a piece of paper. And you can use your erasable pen and a window to transfer your design from paper onto fabric. And so I'm going to show you how to do that right now. So what I do is I take the piece of paper and I tape it to a window. I use tape so I can have both hands for the next part. Then I take my hooped fabric and I lay it the front face up against the pattern, which is on the window. And I use my erasable pen to just transfer the design over by tracing it. I can see it right through the fabric because I've got it up against the window and it's nice and bright. And then I just trace the design onto the fabric. And then you're ready to go. All right, now we're ready to prepare our needle. So you need to pick a floss color that you want to start with. Any color will do. This is called a six-strand pull skein, which means you can just pull the floss to liberate it, right? So there's your skein. There's always a dangly bit, right? Find that dangly bit, hold the skein, and pull. You want to cut yourself about 2 feet, no more than that. Its entire job is to turn itself into a knot, and our entire job is to tame it, and this is all we can tame in any one moment. It's called six-stranded because each strand is actually made up of six strands. That means you can decide how thick or thin a line you want to work with while you're stitching. I like to work with a really thin line, so I'm going to show you what I do. I hold all six strands in one hand, and I don't move this hand. My right hand takes one at a time, and it pulls straight up. Ta-da! So that I could get that one strand out, then I run my hand down the remaining five. Now, if you want to work with more strands, just keep separating them one at a time. Okay, it's important to just do it one at a time, otherwise you get a big knot. So I've got two strands here, and that's good. I think I'm going to work with one today, though, because I really like a thin line. Then we need to thread our needle. So I've got my needle. The first thing I do is put it in my mouth. Not the needle, the floss. Put the floss in your mouth, never the needle. The needle never, ever goes in your mouth, okay? And then what I like to do is hold my floss so you can barely see it between my forefinger and my thumb. And then I sort of jam the needle on top of it. And it's just the fastest way to thread a needle. Now, when we embroider, we work with a long tail and a short tail. So a long side and a short side. The only rule is that the short tail has to be shorter than the long tail. And the reason why is as you're stitching, it's the long tail that's gonna get stitched into the fabric. And you wanna keep an eye on that short tail and keep shortening it while you go. Otherwise, you end up stitching both sides in and then your needle gets stuck and we have to cut it out and it's sad. You're probably definitely gonna do that twice before you learn. It's just part of the fun. So I like to celebrate it. When I do it the first time, I say, yay, that's out of the way. The second time I say, I'm never gonna do that again. And usually I don't. I like to put a knot at the end of the long tail. All I do is just a plain old little knot right at the end of the long tail, just so when I start stitching, the floss stays in place and I don't have to battle it. That's it, your needle is threaded. You've got a knot at the end of your long tail. You got your short tail ready to go. And now you're ready to start stitching. The stitch I'm gonna teach you today is called backstitch. It's my favorite stitch. It's the easiest stitch. It's the most versatile stitch. That said, when you're ready to level up and you wanna like get fancy with it, go to my website, badasscrossstitch.com. Go to the tutorials page, and there are 60 plus different stitch tutorials there. So you can teach yourself all sorts of stitches after you've mastered this one. Okay, so backstitch. We start on the back side of the embroidery and we come up wherever you want, but really I tend to start where I'm gonna write. I pull until my knot hits the back, right? So I know that I'm ready to go. My first stitch moves forward. That's called my anchor stitch, okay? All the stitches after this move backwards, which means I come up away from my last stitch and I share the hole with the previous stitch. And that's the key to backstitch, is that you're sharing the hole with your previous stitch, and that's what makes a nice line. Again, I'm coming up away from my last stitch and I'm sharing the hole with the previous stitch. That's backstitch, y'all. You just do this for days if you'd like, right? You're coming up. I'm making an anchor stitch here since I'm starting a new section. And now I'm going to go ahead and come up away from my last stitch, just like I've been doing. Share the hole with the previous stitch. Now, when you're doing curves like this, the important part is to shorten your stitches and make sure that That makes sure that you are keeping the curve, right? Otherwise, you tend to get real blocky. But if you keep it, your stitches short, it'll keep the curve. And that's it. You just keep going, keep going, keep going. You come up away. You share the hole with the previous stitch. Boom. So what happens if I want to change colors or I start to run out of floss? Let's talk about what tying off the back looks like. All right, so to tie off so that you can either change colors or because you're running out of floss, I go on the back side and I take my needle and I run it underneath a nearby stitch. Okay, which then makes this loop, which then I'm putting the needle through in order to make a knot. And I just pull, give it a little tug, and now that knot is gonna live on that stitch forever and you don't even need to worry about it. You just give it a little trim and then you can rethread and pick up where you left off like nothing even happened. And that'll stay secure with just one knot. Ta-da! Once you're done stitching, you take it out of the hoop. And then what I do is I just run it under tap water, under the faucet, just enough to get all of the blue marker out. Then I lay it flat to dry on a towel. And when it's dry, you can decide what you want to do with it. You could put it back in the hoop and hang it on a wall. This one, I'll probably turn it into a patch that I'll sew onto a bag or a jacket or something. So thanks for hanging out with me, and I hope you had a lot of fun embroidering. I look forward to seeing all of the ways that you use embroidery to express yourself and to decorate and adorn everything you own. Clothing, face masks, bags, jackets. Jean jackets are my favorite. You can find all sorts of tutorials and patterns on my website at badasscrossstitch.com. And I definitely want to see what you make, so be sure to tag me on Insta at badasscrossstitch and use the hashtag CPLRadicalFit so that we can all find each other and check out the rad works that you made. Thanks for hanging out, y'all.